Every human, regardless of color, creed, ethnicity, gender, or geographical location, is searching for happiness. The guaranteed formula for happiness is to count your bounties daily. If you counted your bounties yesterday, you would be happy and blissful. And if you do not count your bounties today, you will be sad, depressed, and miserable. Generally, we speak about two types of bounties, the spiritual bounties, and of course, the worldly and the material bounties. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of both these bounties in one verse amongst many other verses. It's the fifth chapter of the Quran, the sixth juz of the Quran, verse 20. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ جَعْلَ فِيكُمْ أَنْبِيَاءَ. Remember when Sayyidina Musa said to his people, reflect over the favor of Allah upon you, that He created amongst you anbiya, prophets. So the presence of the prophets, of course, is a great source of motivation in terms of spirituality, nobility, direction, etc. From this, the verse releases a hint, فِيهِ أَنَّ كَوْنَ شَخْصٍ مِّن بَيْتِ أَهْلِ اللَّهِ مِنَ النِّعَمِ الَّتِي يَجِبُ الشُّكْرُ عَلَيْهَا لِمَا فِيهِ مِنْ تَسْهِيلِ الدِّينِ عَلَيْهِ نَعَمْ لَا يَجُوزُ التَّفَاخُرُ بِهِ وَلَا الْعُجْبُ بِهِ. Wow! If you're born in a home in which your parents, your surroundings, your neighborhood is religiously conscious, then this is a great boon from the Almighty, because it allows you, it enables you, it motivates you. Your elementary years are spent learning Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So we need to value that. We need to value the bounty that Allah has given us, an environment that's conducive to the preservation of our deen. Count your bounties. وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا. And in the second portion of that same verse, Sayyidina Musa said to his people, and Allah made you kings and rulers. Now, this creates a question mark, apparently, that Allah didn't say He made rulers amongst you. He said He made you all kings, whereas everyone was not a king. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah says, your king does not refer to someone with a throne, but rather the comfortable life they led was no less than a king. And that reminds me of the hadith which Imam Muslim has captured in Kitab al-Zuhud on the strength of Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, that a person came and asked him, أَلَسْنَا مِنْ فُقَرَاءِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ. Are we not from amongst the poor immigrants? So Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu asked him, أَلَكَ زَوْجَةٌ. Do you have a spouse with whom you live? He said, yes. أَلَكَ مَسْكَنٌ تَسْكُنُهُ. Do you have a home in which you reside? He said, indeed. In fact, إِنَّ لِي خَادِمْ. I have a servant and a helper as well. Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu said, فَأَنْتَ مِنَ الْمُلُوكِ. Then you are a king yourself. My brother, my sister, the guaranteed formula, count your bounties daily. I leave you with this reflection. Life will expose you daily to people who have less than you and more than you. The choice is yours, where you decide to fix your gaze.